Hi everyone. Today we will talk about a curious algorithm that allows you to create unique patterns. You can easily find it online by searching the words Physarum or slime mold simulation. Surely, I could not ignore it and I decided to make it myself. The algorithm got such a name because the result is very similar to one very interesting organism. I recommend reading about it online. By slightly changing the rules, you can get completely unexpected patterns, and that's what we are going to do today. Since the algorithm is based on the agents interacting with pheromone trails and generating beautiful patterns, this is a way for me to experiment in areas such as swarm intelligence and generative art. The essence of the algorithm is simple. Numerous agents rush across the field, leaving pheromone trails. They prefer going where there is more pheromone. By slightly changing the parameters of the agents, we can get interesting results. This is an agent. With each turn, he moves, leaving behind a pheromone trail. With each turn, the pheromone evaporates a little, and diffusion occurs. These are the parameters defining the final result. The agent moves at a certain speed, this is the number of pixels by which he moves. There is also an angle by which the agent can change movement direction. All this can be changed within wide limits. The agent has three sensors measuring the amount of pheromones. As parameters, we set the distance to them and the angle of sight sensors. The direction of the agent's movement in the next step depends on which of the sensors detected the largest amount of pheromone. Also, in my version, there are other parameters too. Wobbling. The direction of the agent slightly changes randomly with each turn. A forced turn. With each move, a small value is added to the direction of the agent, turning him towards a certain direction. Well, and here's the coolest feature. If the central sensor detects the amount of pheromones greater than the specified threshold, then the agent, with some probability, may change his strategy and move to a place with less pheromones. All this happens along a number of steps set by another parameter. Some parameters are the same for all the agents. Other parameters have a range, and for each agent, a value from this range is randomly selected. As the final result, the agents are not displayed on the screen, and we see only the pheromone. The color of each image dot depends on the amount of pheromone at that dot. And here comes the final touch. For coloring, I use pre-made gradients. When changing the gradient, it smoothly flows into the new one within a few seconds. On the screen, you can see an example of changing gradients to color the same pattern. A little about the interaction of agents. If this pattern is left for a long time, all clusters will merge into one. It is quite curious to see why this happens. I hope this will give me some ideas for swarm intelligence projects. The agents are visible on the screen. The black ones are in standard mode, looking for places with more pheromones. The pink ones are in inverted mode, running to where there is less pheromones. Since the side sensors are turned backwards, the pink agents, coming to their senses, quickly discover that there are more pheromones behind them, so they return by following their tracks, at the same time providing paths for the agents nearby. As a result, a simple agent algorithm creates a tendency for the clusters to merge. Here is another interesting pattern discovered by accident. For some reason, the agents start creating clear areas. Something like bobbling happens. I have not yet figured out why this happens. I will only note that the sensors are located at a very small angle. Let's look at the agents moving and forming their paths. Now the agents are given a small random angle with each turn. Let's remove it. The paths have become more slender. I've added a small forced turn in one of the directions. Now let's lower the threshold after which the agent starts moving to where there is less pheromone. These agents are displayed in yellow. Let's see how the agents look on other patterns. By the way, sometimes the agents supposed to avoid pheromones in theory. Move in groups, which looks strange. And let me remind you that as the final result, we see only the pheromone, while the agents remain invisible. This is what my program looks like. I wrote it in processing. All calculations are performed by the central processor, so I can't boast high speeds. But with 40,000 agents, it is quite comfortable to work. In the program, you can switch between the saved patterns, change the gradient, manually set parameters, or randomly generate them. I'd like to note that all the most interesting options were generated randomly. Only minor edits were added manually. I even ran the automatic generation of different options, saving several frames per option. As a result, I got a hallucinogenic video lasting for several dozen minutes. But I eventually could not use the results because I forgot to save the most important thing: the parameters of these patterns. Let's check out the Wikipedia article on swarm intelligence. The agents follow very simple rules. Interactions between the agents leading to the emergence of intelligent global behavior, unknown to the individual agents. The algorithm of our agents is very simple. Run to where there is more pheromone. If there is too much pheromone, run to where there is less pheromone. Can you predict what pattern will result from the interaction of a swarm of such agents? And these ones? Or these ones? The simplicity of the algorithm of a single agent turns into the complexity of creating the desired swarm behavior. Apparently, that's why I got the majority of the most interesting patterns randomly. And all this very easily falls into a genetic algorithm. The only thing is that the goal of the swarm should not be subjective, like creating a beautiful pattern. It should be objective and algorithmically evaluated. We can also make the algorithm of an individual agent more complex if we wish so. Any parameters can be made dynamic, depending on certain conditions. In addition to running after the pheromone and from the pheromone, you can add other modes, and the rules for switching between them. All this excites my mind. Leave your options in the comments below. What else can be added or changed? And please, support us on Patreon. The more support we get, the more opportunities we have for new experiments. That's all for now. Bye everyone.